It appears that a volcanic eruption could be imminent at Hawaii's Kilauea Volcano for the first time this year. The uptick in activity began at around 3:08 a.m. local time on January 31st when a strong earthquake swarm began at Kilauea's summit region. This earthquake swarm was fairly strong, but more importantly, occurred at very shallow depths of 1 to 2 kilometers. For context, this figure marks the approximate depth of Kilauea's shallow magma chamber, with quakes shallower than 1 kilometer depth clearly indicating the upward migration of magma into its magma conduit, which leads to the surface. Yet, along with the recent ground deformation, there is another unusual feature of Kilauea's current unrest. What I am referring to is the fact that most of Kilauea's recent earthquakes are primarily occurring within its southwest rift zone, which has not been the site of a volcanic eruption since 1974. For comparison, Kilauea's east rift zone has seen 4 major eruptions in the time since. These earthquakes clearly indicate the movement of magma, but not all is as it seems. While the location of these earthquakes might lead some people to believe that a southwest rift zone eruption might soon occur, I am a bit more skeptical. While it is fully possible that such an eruption might occur, I instead am interpreting that these quakes represent the influx of magma into an increasingly pressurized magma storage area which underlies the pathway any magma would take during a southwest rift zone eruption. I would suggest a southwest rift zone eruption is likely only if earthquakes migrated further north and then southwest of their current location instead of essentially occurring in the same place as several other weaker earthquake swarms that have occurred since October of 2023. Although I admit that a southwest rift zone eruption is fully possible at this time, if an eruption was to occur, I would currently expect it to erupt via a series of vents in the southwest portion of Kilauea's summit caldera. As a result of all this activity, Kilauea's alert level was raised from yellow to orange by the US Geological Survey at 4:41 a.m. local time. Yet, I would not currently recommend rushing over to one of Kilauea's open safe viewing areas to await the beginning of a new eruption quite yet. As, while earthquake activity did continue to get stronger and stronger for 3 hours straight, a notable decline in seismic energy release has occurred in the hours since. This occurred alongside a drop in the caldera's tilt, suggesting that either A, the magmatic intrusion got close but failed to reach the surface, or B, the intrusion has reached such shallow depths that it does not generate any earthquakes and an eruption will soon begin. Statistically speaking, scenario B is far more likely as most magmatic intrusions do not result in a volcanic eruption. The good news is that whether an eruption occurs in the southwest rift zone or Kilauea's caldera, if it does occur, it would be most likely completely effusive and not threaten any nearby structures. The only hazard Kilauea's potentially imminent eruption could generate are heightened levels of toxic gas emissions such as sulfur dioxide and carbon dioxide, which in high levels can be deadly, but have not historically reached lethal concentrations at nearby homes in the town of Volcano during Kilauea's recent eruptions. However, were an eruption to occur, people should avoid all outdoor activities while directly downwind of any eruption plume. As a final note, I would like to thank Juzilla Maui for increasing their Patreon tier on this channel's Patreon page.